Okay, welcome back to Likras. We're working on Parshas Pikudei. The Torah starts with the phrase Eid Pikudei Mishkan, Mishkan Eidus Sher Pukad Al Pi Moshe. The word Pikudei is emphasized, it's named the Parsha. And Pshat Pikudei means an accounting of all the items that are used for building the Mishkan, the Tabernacle, and the Wilderness. Notes, the Yismach Moshe. The word Pikudei also has a different definition in other contexts, meaning mitzvahs. Targum Monklis, when it's translated to the mitzvah, says Eid Pikudei. And if we add to this an idea that the Gemara in Shabbos says, that Moshe Rabbeinu destroyed the first set of the Luchos HaBris, the Ten Commandments. Nasa Moshe Kavachomer Ba'asmo. He made a Kavachomer. What do we find by Korban Pesach? That now we're in the Halday of Pesach. The Korban Pesach, the sacrifice of itself. It's a mitzvah saying, the Torah says that Kol Ben Nechar Lo Yochobo, says any person who has estranged himself from HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he's called a mumer, he's not allowed to bring the korban pesach, not allowed to eat it, the Torah says. So, said Moshe Rabbeinu, if that's true by one mitzvah, kol Torah kula, v'kol Yisroel mumorim, alachas kamer kama. All the more so, we cannot receive the Ten Commandments, cannot receive the Torah of the giving at the time of the Ten Commandments, which is Shivasa B'Tammuz, after Shavuos. Why? Because all of Yisrael, they're having this egel azov, this golden calf. That is what the Gemara says. So it comes out, notes the Yismach Moshe, that were it not for the Mishkan that provides a kapara, then we, Klal Yisrael, will not have Torah mitzvahs. And so this is the Eidus, when the Pasuk says that Pikudei Mishkan Eidus, it's telling us that we get the Torah, it's dependent on Mishkan and the kapara that Mishkan brings. And also, the word Pekuv Dalet Pikudei can also mean to be lacking. So Pasuk that goes that way. And so it's lacking. The Pasuk says, Pukad al Pi Moshe. What's it mean, lacking? Haynu, the Luchas Rishonis. Next we'll be talking about Pi Moshe. Moshe Rabbeinu is the one who took us away from the Luchas, destroyed the Luchas. It was Moshe doing this Lima that he had from the Korban Pesach. And now we know that the Torah is dependent on the Mishkan due to it being lacked by Moshe. So the words of the Torah, when it says, Pukudei Mishkan, Mishkan Yisachar, Pukad al Pi Moshe, the word Pukudei comes up twice and it seems like it's totally redundant in some kind of count. Again, the level of Remez. The first Pikudei means the mitzvahs, learning from the mitzvah Korban Pesach. And the second Pikudei means it would be lacking. And what is lacking? The first tablets that were destroyed by Moshe Rabbeinu, that was correct to destroy them, that helps us that after Mishkan comes and we get a kapara for the golden calf, then we're able to get the Torah.